Hi, I'm Brian Koberlein. I'm an astrophysicist, and this is The Universe Unleashed. Today I'm going to talk about the search for the planet Vulcan. Not the Star Trek planet, but an actual planet that astronomers thought might exist closer to the Sun than Mercury. It all starts in the 1850s when Urbain Le Verrier measured the orbit of Mercury very precisely. And if you look at the orbit of Mercury, it's a little bit of an ellipse. So you have the Sun, you have Mercury moving around like that. And what Le Verrier found was that the orbit of Mercury was doing something rather interesting. Instead of staying in a perfect ellipse like this, it would actually shift slightly over time. Now this was a very small amount. We're talking about a few seconds every orbit of 88 days. And part of this is due to the gravitational interactions of the other planets. So Venus and Earth and other planets would pull just very slightly on Mercury, causing its orbit to shift or precess very slowly over time. But there was this extra little bit. There was this little bit that was about a second every orbit that wasn't accounted for by the other planets. So one of the proposals was that within the orbit of Mercury would be another planet that they named Vulcan, and they tried to search for this planet from about the 1850s on. And the problem is that Mercury is already very close to the Sun, and Vulcan would be even closer to the Sun, and you can't see it very easily. You'd either have to look for it to transit in front of the Sun, to pass in front of the Sun and cast a shadow, or you try to look for it during a solar eclipse when you could try to see without the glare of the Sun. And there were actually a couple of cases in which they thought they might have seen it, but it failed. And so they kept looking. But in 1915, Albert Einstein came out with an alternative. And that alternative was that this precession of Mercury's orbit was not due to a planet closer to the Sun. It was actually due to the fact that gravity is not simply a force of attraction between masses. It's actually a curvature of space and time. So Einstein's theory of general relativity actually accounted for this very small shift in the orbit of Mercury. So what began as a search for a planet Vulcan ended with the first evidence that space and time is curved. And there you have it, the search for a planet that never was. Of course, Mercury has a little bit of an elliptical orbit, and Urbain Le Verrier, sorry, I've got to stop.